Starting with SoJo 2023 Release 1, it's now possible to use the charts control in both your desktop and iOS projects in the same way you've been doing with your SoJo web projects. In fact, the charts control on desktop and iOS offers nearly the same set of features and behavior that was available for web projects since SoJo 2020. For example, it's possible to see the values moving the pointer cursor over any of the chart bars or points for any of the supported chart types, such as line, bar, pie, donut, polar area, scattered or bubble, amongst others. Additionally, it's also possible to combine different chart datasets in the same chart, such as several datasets that have a bar type with other datasets whose type is set to line. With some of the chart control features, the user will also be able to hide or display any of the displayed datasets by clicking on the legend, setting the font type and size that will be dynamically adjusted based on the size of the control, and also setting other properties. For example, the filling transparency values, the background color of the chart, the color of the grid, or make the values pop up visible or not. All in all, the way the chart works uses the same code you are already using in your web projects, with the logical exception that the underlying data types don't have the web prefix. In the documentation, you can find all of the properties, methods, and events available for both the chart control itself and the related classes for the datasets. An additional feature added to charts for desktop and iOS is the ability to export the chart to PDF in a vectorial way. That means that the resulting PDF file will keep full resolution no matter the zoom scale used in the visualization. All the text used in the chart will be searchable, and the representation of the chart data itself is also vectorial. As you can see here in this example project that's supported for all chart types, and in addition, you'll even be able to set both the width and the height for the rendered chart in the PDF file. If we look into the same example project for iOS, we can see that its behavior is exactly as the same as it is on the desktop. The chart control on iOS supports the same chart types and also offers the same UI experience, with some expected differences to better enhance and adapt the control to the smaller screen sizes of iOS devices. They also use the tap actions instead of using a mouse cursor as the main device. The mobile chart control also supports exporting any of the chart types to a PDF file, keeping the full vectorial quality in the resulting file. So if we open the exported PDF file in the iOS device itself, we can see how we get the expected output at full resolution. And that's all. So from now on, you will be able to create the same graphic charts from web, also on desktop and iOS, applying what you already know from the web chart control. If you have any questions, please put them below in the comments.